Dear students, in this video, I am going to talk on autoclave validation. So, we will discuss the principle, definitions, various types of autoclave, sterilization cycle, load types, validation definition, types of validation, and references. Principle, in this diagram you can see how steam come in the chamber. Here you can see the various points, this exhaust wall, steam chamber, safety wall is there, pressure gauge for regulation of the pressure, operating wall, the door, the steam chamber, air, inlet and outlet, pressure regulator, automatic ejector. Principle, sterilization means the complete destruction of all forms of microbial life including bacterial spores, viruses, fungi, bacteria. Autoclave maintains saturated steam for period of time at high temperature and under pressure. Steam contact a cooler surface condenses, causing a huge decrease in volume and setting up a negative pressure that draws more steam. Action of steam ensures surface heating, penetration, denaturation of critical proteins and nucleic acids occurs within the cell. Denaturation results in the breakdown of intramolecular hydrogen bonds between the protein. The structure and function of microbes is lost. Definition, sterility assurance level. The probability of a single viable microorganisms being present on a sterilized product is 1 in 1 million after completion of sterilization process. Bioburden, the number or type of viable microorganisms contaminating a product. Overkill approach, a sterilization approach based on assuming worst case conditions. A bioburden of 10^6 of a highly heat resistant bacteria. D value, time in minutes at a specific temperature to reduce the surviving microbial population by 90%, one log reduction. Z value, temperature change required resulting in a one log reduction in D value. F value, the number of minutes to keep a specified number of microorganisms with a specified Z value at a specific temperature. F zero value, the number of minutes to keep a specified number of microorganisms with a Z value of 10°C, 50°F at a temperature of 121.1°C. See some graph for the D value and Z value. You can see in the first graph on the x axis the time of exposure in the minutes, on the y axis the population. Second one, the graph is effect of temperature on D value as well as the Z value. Autoclave types, first gravity, based on the principle of gravity most commonly used. Steam is pumped into the top of chamber, air is forced out bottom during the conditioning phase. You can see in the diagram. Second, pre-vacuum type, uses a vacuum pump to remove air from chamber prior to sterilization. Post vacuum drying phase ensures dryness. Steam able to penetrate all surfaces within the chamber. Let's have a look on the basic sterilization cycle. What is going to happen? First, heating is going to take place. Then the main function is occur, the sterilization of the material. Then depressurize, release of pressure, and the cycle will complete. steam enter the chamber, conditions are loaded, air displaced through chamber drain, steam processes load at selected time and temperature, steam is removed from chamber and pressure is released. Usually it consists of three phases. First is heating phase. Steam enters the sterilizer jacket and air is removed from the sterilizer chamber either by gravity displacement or mechanic prevent. Sterilization phase. Load is exposed to steam at a set temperature, measured and controlled by a temperature sensor in the drain line for a set time. Next one, cool down drying phase. Sterilizer chamber is exhausted to atmospheric pressure followed by circulating air through the chamber or by drawing a deep vacuum. Jacket heat is maintained during the drying phase. Design of any basic sterilization. The validation. The term validation is most important. The basic meaning of validation is that to cross-check the particular, it may be equipment or process. Currently, we are discussing on the autoclave validation, that is a type of product validation, that is an equipment validation. So we are going to check all the things in the validation. As we are familiar with the calibration, in the calibration, we will check the accuracy. We are checking the accuracy in the validation. The validation of the steam sterilization cycle is dependent on the equipment chosen. The sterilizer and its support systems must be designed and constructed to deliver the effective cycles repeatedly and consistently. Qualification of the autoclave consists of proper design, installation according to design, and operational testing to ensure design criteria and specification are met. All steam sterilization cycles are based on direct contact with saturated steam. Saturated steam is water vapor which is in the equilibrium with the liquid. Saturated steam can exist only along the phase boundary, that is, relation between its temperature and pressure is fixed. This is the water steam phase diagram. You can see pressure is given in the millimeter Hg versus the temperature, and also pressure is given in Pascal. This is the water steam phase diagram. Some characteristics of the modern steam sterilization: pressure vessel, steam jacket and insulation, safety door, thermostatic steam trap, temperature control system, cycle timer, microbial retentive vent filter, chamber pressure indicator. Load types and various samples which we are placing in sterilizers. That is, the use of autoclave are used to sterilize several different types of loads, different materials. You can see in the slides that solid, metal, glass, plastic, porous materials, linen, gowns, paper, gauze, complex instrument, hollow tubes, liquid, water, saline, various medias, laboratory waste, petri dishes, sample bottles, syringes. So, validation. As per WHO, it is defined as the documented act of proving that any procedure, process, equipment, material, activity or system actually leads to the expected results. A system must be qualified to operate in a validated process. Qualify a system or equipment. Presently we are studying the equipment validation. Validate a process. Qualification versus validation. Example, you qualify an autoclave whereas you validate sterilization process. So that is the difference versus a qualification and validation. This pyramid, you can see that in validation, which type of qualifications are done to qualify a particular instrument? First is preliminaries, including equipment design qualification, then installation qualification, operational qualification, performance qualification, and lastly the maintenance is needed, if needed, change control, and if any change is required, then after changing the procedure or process or equipment, requalification is needed. So installation qualification should include the following checks: that the electrical supply is suitable for the autoclave, that the temperature and humidity are sufficiently well controlled, that there is no interference to or from other equipment, the accuracy of indicators has been certified to national standards, the temperature and pressure of the chamber during a sterilization cycle are within specifications, the leakage into the chamber during a vacuum cycle does not exceed the specified maximum, that there is no leakage of steam, water, or effluent at any point during the sterilization cycle, that both water quality and steam quality comply with sterilizer specifications, the chamber is capable of withstanding its specified maximum pressure. This test may be a legal requirement and should be performed by a suitably certified organization. Mechanical equipment specification: chamber, walls, traps, strainers, filters, regulators, vacuum pump, heat exchanger, condenser, etc. Control and instrument specifications: programmable logic controller, operator interface, printer, recorder, control valves, transducers, pressure and temperature transmitters, resistance, temperature devices, switches, level sensors, interlocks, photocells, site specifications or utilities, power, grounding, surge protector, uninterruptible power supply, breakers, water, clean steam, plant steam, drain, isolation walls, approval documentation, for example, pressure vessel, electrical supply lines, bill of materials, vendor specification sheets, purchase order, preventive maintenance program, IP installation, verification, operating and maintenance manuals, control system documentation, system configuration, block diagram, flow sheets, display layouts, general process limit, data monitoring, software inventory, electronic application, code listing, system security, operational qualification. Let's have a look what the testings are given. Basic meaning that whether it is operated normally or within the limits or not, that it is intended to demonstrate that the components of the autoclave operate properly and that the autoclave is deemed ready for performance or load testing. So that include the following checks: leak day, jacket mapping, saturated steam test, all these things. Empty chamber heat distribution studies to record the temperature, thermocouples are needed. So you can see this diagram, thermocouples are there, their positions and their locations are given to measure the temperature. Container mappings, different points are there, upper, middle and lower points. Performance qualification, in that the steam penetration strengths. Intents of the study is to determine the coolest point within specified load. Load cool points are dependent on the type of object that compose the load, that is liquid filled container, process equipment, and different points are there. The microorganisms most frequently used to challenge moist heat sterilization cycles are Bacillus stereothermophilus and Clostridium spongiferus. These studies are typically conducted concurrently with the heat penetration studies. So all about as well. Last is the references. Some way, thank you.